to the July 9th Solon Planning Commission meeting. We'll begin with a Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Carol, may we please have a roll call?
Mr. Bentley?
Here.
Mayor Drucker?
Here.
Mr. Mazur?
Here.
Mr. Newberry?
Here.
Ms. Richmond?
Here.
Okay, changes to the agenda, and there are several. Item numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, and 9 will be tabled tonight. At this time, I'll entertain comments from the audience. Comments from the audience? Seeing none, return to the table. I'll accept the motion to approve the minutes if appropriate.
Moved.
Second.
By Mackey, seconded by Roger. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Abstain.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
On our pending agenda, item number 1, Cannon Road and Psalm Center Road, permanent parcels 951-39006, 952-09001, and 952-12004, Burton Insurance Agency, Incorporated, Mary Lambert. This is tabled at a 6:25 meeting. We will be scheduling a public hearing for our next meeting, which is July 23rd. And I'll make that a motion.
Second.
Seconded by the mayor. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Item number 2 is 34500 Dogwood Lane, Frank and Cheryl Radis. This is tabled at our previous two meetings. They have not brought forth any new information, so I will make a motion to table.
I'll second that.
Seconded by Tony. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Item number 3 on our pending agenda, 32800 Solon Road, Creative Playrooms. This is tabled at our last meeting and referred to Safety and Public Properties. That meeting is tomorrow, so this will be covered at our next meeting, which is July 23rd. I'll accept a motion to table.
Moved.
Moved by Roger.
Second.
Seconded by Mackey. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
And number 4 on the pending agenda, Sherwood Park. Sherwood Park Homeowners Association. This is tabled at our last meeting. The applicant has requested to be to postpone this to our next meeting. Therefore, I'll accept a motion to table.
So moved.
By Tony.
Second.
Seconded by Roger. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
We have arrived at the new part of our agenda, 33800 Miles Road, Aaron Solomon, for a 7-foot minimum side yard setback variance. My understanding is that the applicant phoned into the planning department and asked to be tabled tonight. I'll accept a motion to table.
Moved.
By Mackey.
Second.
Seconded by the mayor. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Item number 6, we finally get to talk about something here.
Move to adjourn.
Item number 6 on the new agenda, 39910 Aurora Road, Lisa Ross for Station 43 for site plan approval for a deck modification and an 88-foot front yard setback variance. Good evening.
Good evening. I'm David Gentile with Neville Architects, representing Station 43 for the side yard setback, or front yard setback, sorry. What they propose to do would be to remove this existing ramp up the deck and remove the bar and a portion of the screen wall to extend the deck for more standing room. We would provide a gate to exit for exit only emergency egress with a step down. The ADA entrance now would be around to this door where they would come basically across the parking lot and into the door into the back of the restaurant.
Okay. Just for the record, there is no additional seating associated with this remodel?
That is my understanding. That's correct.
And there are no awnings as part of this plant or umbrellas at this point?
That is correct.
Okay. Commission members, questions?
I'll make a motion for a site plan approval for the deck modification at 39910 Aurora Road.
Second.
Seconded by Roger. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
I'll move for an 88-foot front yard setback variance.
Second that.
Seconded by Tony. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
David, you'll be before City Council at their next meeting, which is Monday, July 15th.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Item number seven on the new agenda, 33650 Baldwin Road, Kim Dykes, for 5-foot minimum cumulative side yard setback variance for the garage, 5-foot minimum side yard setback for pavement, a 5-foot minimum driveway setback variance, and 11-foot square foot maximum accessory pavement variance. Good evening.
Good evening. My name is John D'Amico. I'm the general contractor with the Great Garage Company. And my plan, all we're looking to do here, let's see, oh, there we go. We're looking to move the existing garage, which is in this location right here. You should all have prints on that, showing that. And the existing driveway, which is right over here, we're replacing. We're just taking it out and putting it in the exact same location. So that that existing driveway currently runs right alongside the property line, like you see there. And then right over here is the existing garage, which is also right on the property line. So all we want to do is move a new garage back about 8 feet from the existing one and move it off the line by 5 feet and allow them to have better access getting in and out of the current garage, which is only 22 feet away from the house right now.
Okay. Commission members, any questions?
No, I would just comment that we've had similar situations with them because you have the narrow driveways over there. So I'll support the request for variances based on, and I think we've done this quite a few times in the past as well due to same circumstances with just trying to improve access in and out.
Correct.
I think one of the conditions, as we talked about in caucus, is we would like to see a lot consolidation in the future. I think you're in the process of doing that anyway, so.
They are in the process. We have the lot consolid, the survey was just completed, and that's this right over here. So okay. They'll be submitting that and having that taken care of then.
Okay.
I see a note for gutters here on the existing garage. Are you going to have gutters on the new garage as well?
There will be gutters, and they will be tied into the storm sewer.
I'd like to make a motion for 33650 Baldwin Road for a 5-foot minimum cumulative side yard setback for the garage.
I'll second that.
Seconded by Tony. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
And I'll make a motion for a 5-foot minimum side yard setback variance for the pavement.
Second.
Seconded by the mayor. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
I'll move to approve a 5-foot minimum driveway setback variance.
I'll second that.
Seconded by Tony. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yep.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes. And I'll make a motion for 11 square foot maximum accessory pavement variance.
Second.
Would you accept a condition?
With the contingency that the lot consolidation be filed with the city in with all deliberate speed. I'm not going to set a definite time frame.
Thank you for modifying my motion. You want to second that now?
I'll second the motion so that you can first it.
Okay. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
You'll be before City Council their next meeting, which is Monday the 15th.
Great. Thank
Best
you.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Item number eight on the new agenda, 32001 Cannon Road, Church of the Resurrection, 75-foot front yard setback variance for a fountain and supporting structure, an 8.5-foot front yard setback variance for decorative sitting wall, 1-foot sign height variance, and a site plan for landscaping for fountain alterations. Good evening.
Good evening. I'm Doug Nemeke. I'm the landscape architect representing the church. I'm also a Solon resident.
What we're proposing for the church is, starting off, is a brand-new entrance sign, a main sign. The sign that we have on the site now is a masonry white brick sign with tin lettering, and we'd like to upgrade that sign and get a little bit more creative with a new idea. On the site right now is a large stone fountain, which is sort of the genesis for the new design. We'd like to move that actual fountain that is a little bit further to the east of where we're proposing the new sign, and then combine it with the sign so that there's sort of a combination of the sign with the fountain behind it. And the material that we're proposing for the sign is some sort of rough-hewn sandstone boulders, similar to the fountain itself, and then a large solid sign section, which would probably be, oh, I don't know, 6 to 8 inches wide, but again, sort of rough-edged and a little bit rustic. We haven't come to any decision on the engraving of the sign or the lettering, but that's something we hopefully can work out moving forward. As a part of moving the fountain and creating the new sign, we are trying to create an overall area in front of the church that we can bring a new walkway from the city sidewalk up to the front of the church through. And as a part of doing that, we would like to incorporate some seating and modify the walkway so that there's an opportunity for people to sit and pause and maybe spend some time in this garden area and just enjoy it and enjoy the fountain, which we hope to get water through again, which it hasn't had water pumped through it in probably 5 or 6 years, maybe 10. So the overall theme then really represents the sign, the fountain, the bench seating, the new walkway, and then sort of an all-encompassing garden around that.
Doug, the question I have to ask you is the depth of the pool for the fountain.
Well, you know, we're going to fill the fountain up. It's going to be what they can call a waterless fountain. So we'll have water in it, but there won't be any type of a drowning hazard. It'll be filled with gravel, but we need a reservoir of water to move through the fountain itself. So it'll either be filled with gravel, or there's other methods that are being employed nowadays to create a void beneath the gravel so that we can still have a nice water reservoir and keep it clean, but there's no way that anybody could enter into it.
Depth won't exceed 2 feet, then.
Pardon?
The depth will not exceed 2 feet.
It doesn't need to. Well, the water itself,
yes.
That's within the gravel?
Yes. No, I guess the code requires if it's 2 feet, it's considered a pool. So that's what I'm asking. Is it the depth of the water that would be unobstructed would be less than 2 feet?
Correct.
Okay, that's what I was looking for. Commission members, questions? Oh, lighting, Doug?
Well, I think that, and when I mentioned it to you earlier, I was mistaken. There's going to be probably 2 spotlights, uplights on the sign itself in front, which we have now. I think we're going to incorporate some recessed lighting into the bench seating, into the masonry seating. And then I think we're going to uplight the fountain as well. We'll probably have a couple uplights coming out of the four corners or a couple corners of the basin, just to throw a very general illumination on the fountain itself.
Linda, would that require any photometrics considerations?
Yes, it would, even though it's minimal.
Okay. So we'll make that a contingent that you'll submit photometrics.
Photometrics, all right.
Before the council meeting?
Pardon me?
Before council.
Okay.
Before council meeting next week?
Yeah.
15? I'll try.
Okay. Well, I guess we could always, they could all, if we approve it tonight, they could always postpone it to the next meeting.
Right.
We don't currently have a lighting engineer involved on the project, so if it's something that, we'll try our best.
Okay. If not, what I'm saying is, assuming it's approved tonight, you can always table to the next meeting for the meet with them on the 22nd. So.
Okay. Very good. Thank you.
Or the 29th, I guess it would be.
Talking to council?
The second meet, not the next.
No, they don't meet till August.
Planning is 23rd.
23rd, okay. All right?
All right.
Doug, how tall is the existing fence there? I mean, sign, I'm sorry.
The sign that's there now, I believe it's about 42 inches, 36 to 42 inches. It's a much longer sign. It well exceeds the 30-square-foot standard that we have now. But we're making every attempt to make this sign, you know, comply with what the new code is.
Linda, does this have to be reviewed by the landscape person? There's not enough detail here, Doug, on landscaping, by the way.
I'll work on that.
Do you know a good landscape architect?
Does it have to be reviewed by the landscape architect?
Our landscape architect did review it. She did recommend approval. She did have some comments about attempting to save some of the spruce trees, but the planning director can look at that next week.
Okay, okay.
The spruce trees have done very well there. I mean, they've covered the old sign, the old sign. You know, I hate to say that I've been around long enough that I remember when that was the new sign, but the spruce trees have done very well to cover that sign pretty effectively, especially from the east.
Yeah, from the east, for sure. Yeah, you have to get right in front of the sign to see it.
Yep.
Any additional questions? I guess we're ready to move on?
Okay, then I'll move to approve a 75-foot front yard setback variance for the fountain and supporting structure for 32001 Cannon Road.
I'll second that.
Seconded by Tony. Discussion, roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes, and I'll move to approve an 8.5-foot front yard setback variance for the decorative sitting wall.
Second.
Seconded by Roger. Discussion, roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
I'll move for a 1-foot sign height variance.
Second.
By Mackey. Discussion, roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
I'd like to make the motion for the site plan for landscape slash fountain alteration.
Contingent.
Contingent on?
Photometrics.
Photometrics being submitted when?
Soon as possible.
Soon as possible, Doug. Thank you.
I'll second. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
It'll be before city council, their next meeting on the 15th.
Very good.
Very good. Good luck.
Thank you.
Item number nine on the new agenda, 36200 Pettibone Road, Annex Management Incorporated, site plan and alteration for new lighting. Linda has informed us tonight that the photometrics plan that was submitted needs to be revised, so I will make a motion to table this item to our next meeting.
Second.
Seconded by the mayor. Discussion, roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Item number 10, 32875 Solon Road, Hartville Professional Building Center Incorporated for 21-space total onsite parking variance.
First of all, thank you for getting us on the agenda this evening. It was sort of a last-minute thing. We do appreciate Linda's help and the planning department in getting us here. And I guess we appreciate all of your help, too, making this project even a possibility. It was a old racquetball club back in 2010, and with the help of the planning commission and council, we were able to redevelop and repurpose that property into a pretty nice office space. Our first tenant in the building was Keller Williams, and Peter Formica is here with Keller Williams. If you do have any questions that you might want to ask on their behalf. They've grown, added agents as they've established themselves here in Solon, and they're continuing to do that, and that's really what has prompted our request for a variance on the parking so that they could continue to grow. And we also have been fortunate, we have a dermatological provider that is going to be opening within the next week in the building. And again, we appreciate the help of the fire department, building department, and engineering in helping make that possible as well. So we've been fortunate that the property is redeveloping nicely. We're filling it up with tenants, and we think very desirable tenants that are going to be good neighbors in Solon. And that's why we're here to request variance, and I apologize for this being perhaps slightly different than the file copy that you might have at the planning department. I think we're within one space of what was originally submitted, but somehow it was restriped slightly differently. And we have basically this space available. We will be looking to increase the Keller Williams suite by approximately 1,600 square feet, which is the area at the top of the page here. They currently occupy this area here, adjacent to it. The dermatological provider is here, Apex Dermatology, should be opening in the next week or so. And we'll have vacant space in the back of a little over 2,000 square feet for future tenants. And my understanding is that in the foresight and assistance, the planning department has calculated that we'll need 21 spaces to be able to re-tenant the entire property. As we redeveloped this property, I don't know if anyone remembers, I know some of you are here, but we actually had about 17,000 square feet in this building, and we removed the mezzanine to shrink the building floor plate as much as we could. So we've pretty much maxed out the pavement. We've paved every inch that we could pave here on this site, and we've minimized the square footage of the space to be occupied inside the building. And that's why we're here this evening, to request that you approve a variance for the 21 spaces so we can completely tenant the building out.
And just for the record, the vacant area of the building could have been calculated as office space or medical. Office space requires fewer parking spaces, but rather than have them come back in the event that he had a medical tenant, simplify the process to make it expedient for occupancy, we're recommending a 21-space parking variance with the anticipation that if a medical facility does move in, it'll be covered. So, commission members?
I just congratulate you on
thanks
filling out the building. Congratulate Keller Williams for the success that they've had in expanding the office. Look forward to seeing even more of those silly red signs wandering around. As long as they're only up for 2 or 3 weeks at a time, I'm good with it. Mr. Chairman, I would be happy to make a motion to grant a 21-space total on-site parking variance for the Hartfield Professional Center.
Second.
Seconded by Mackey. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
You'll be before City Council next meeting, which is Monday the 15th.
Great. Thank you.
Best of luck.
Appreciate all your help, son.
Thank you. Best of luck to you.
Thanks.
Linda, any minor alterations?
One. Verizon Wireless at 30201 Aurora Road. It's at the northeast corner of the property. The property is owned by Cosmo Solon. The proposal is to replace out six existing antennas. The elevation of the tower at the 165-foot elevation. There's six antennas there now. The proposal is to replace all six of them. They're panel-style antennas. That's kind of the typical tall and narrow antennas. The three of the new antennas are actually going to be slightly larger, but no more than 6 to 8 inches taller than the existing ones. There will be two pieces of equipment also added at this elevation, and it's to assist with their signal strength. So this piece of equipment is going to be added to the pole, and then another piece of equipment is going to be added to the back side of the antennas, so they'll project out from the tower a little bit more than the existing antennas. And the city's review consultant did recommend approval of the plans for the structural analysis.
Anybody want to see any more antenna? We don't want to see any more, Linda. That's
no,
fine.
Right.
Thank you. This time we'll have comments from the commission, beginning with the mayor.
I have no comments tonight. Thank you. Although Linda did a wonderful job. When you're here, there's never any controversy or issues. I don't know what that means, but thank you.
She arranged everything tabled.
I had to plan it that way.
Tony?
No comments tonight.
Roger?
I just want to remind everybody not to buy any of these Solon Home Day raffle tickets, because the fewer that you buy, the better my chances are of winning.
I might turn your stubs in if you're lucky.
There's a first time for everything, though.
Mackey?
No comments tonight.
Linda?
No comments.
Nothing this evening.
Carol?
No comments.
Tenet?
Nope.
Carrie?
No comments.
Lada?
No comments.
I have no comments. Linda, you did a great job.
Thank you.
You're welcome back anytime.
All right.
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second that.
Second by Tony. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Sure.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
This meeting is adjourned.